A lot of attention in this presidential election is focusing on what voters on Main Street are thinking. But do the candidates really know what's going on there?
Well, we wanted to know, so we sent News 8's Matt Barcaro to Main Street Mechanicsburg to ask you how you've weathered the last 4 years and how that's influencing your vote in the upcoming election.
Tonight, Matt continues his Main Street Matters by talking with a teacher.
One of the issues that is not discussed a lot on the campaign trail but affects a lot of people is education. There's a school on Main Street Mechanicsburg for the youngest of learners, and a teacher there wishes the candidates for president would pay more attention to them.
As chaotic as this looks, and as chaotic as it sounds, this is part of a pretty typical day inside Ricky Lee Steele's preschool classroom.
Penny, we're going to have to put this away soon.
And she loves it.
You are the foundation. Like, as a teacher, you are the one that influences their day.
It is on the rug right away.
Ricky Lee teaches 3 and 4 year olds at the Mechanicsburg Learning and Play Center.
Henry had to had a great time playing tag for a while.
It's in a church on Main Street.
It's about the kids. It's the new generation that's coming about. You know, we need to think about these people. They might be the new, I don't know, chef, the new politician, the new reporter or whatnot. So we need to make sure that we have this foundation and this program set in place and we have the funding for it.
Do you have red on your shirt, Ava?
That funding has been harder to come by as local, state, and federal budgets have tightened. This year, the program cut transportation, and the teachers' salaries haven't gone up in 6 years.
You can't live a wonderful lifestyle. You can live. But yeah, I wish we would be paid a little bit more. I wish education would be given a little bit more thought.
Ricky Lee was raised in South Africa and is working towards becoming a U.S. citizen, so she can't vote in this election. But she knows when she can vote, she'll be looking for presidential candidates with education as a top priority.
They should be saying that, you know, rather spending money on high school stuff or college stuff or whatnot, take a little bit of that money and put it into the funding for early childhood programs.
She sees how her students grow from just 3 hours a day in a classroom together, and not just in their learning. 16 of the 20 students in her class are at least 300% below the poverty line. They eat breakfast together in the morning, and some stay after class for lunch. The meals, instruction, and social time give them opportunity.
They might not be able to get it anyway. No, and that's why these 3 hours are so important.
She knows not every community can afford a pre-K program like hers, but she believes a little leadership from today's politicians could change that to the benefit of tomorrow's leaders.
And tomorrow at 6, Matt talks to a voter who fits into one of three groups of the most sought-after voters in this election, a middle-class senior woman. You'll see why she's doing more than voting in this election.